Business Solutions since May 2010. As a qualified professional, he possesses an attitude of go-getter coupled with multitasking abilities in driving team efforts towards achievement of organizational goals with efficient skills. He is comfortable interacting with multiple levels of organization, management and staff, proficient in developing and streamlining systems with proven ability to enhance operational effectiveness and meet operational goals within the cost, time and quality parameters. Over to you now, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity to speak on the evaluation of the institute, inviting me over here. How I can share my screen now? Hello. स्क्रीन शेअर करायचं कसं करू? खाली बटन आहे त्याच्या होतं का? ओके 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 गॉट इट. कॅन यू सी माय स्क्रीन नाउ? या ओके ओके ओके. जस्ट आय एम क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस अँड देन विल स्टार्ट. Okay, let us have some very interesting thought that whenever we discuss upon the technology evolution, we feel that the Western has the upper hand, and we believe that they are having the resources capable enough, and we do not have the capacity to having the things developed. But it is not true. If you can see, we have a very simple thing that is called panchang, which gives you correct timing whenever this solar or moon eclipse occurring, whenever there is high tide and low tide, and this is available since 5000 year back. But when NASA introduced all kind of things and they find out that the earth is round, when they visited the moon, thereafter they have started this kind of thing. But earlier we have seen that in Varahavatara, we have round earth shown in our sculptures also, as well as we say Bhugol, we say that our Prithvi is gol. But earlier it was not discussed in the European countries and there on. The battery technology inventor is all of you know, that is Alexandra Volta in 1800. One of the most enduring batteries, the lead acid battery, was invented by him in 1859, and still the technology used to start most internal combustion engines. We specifically cover the battery related to vehicles, lesser on the other batteries. The evolution of battery technology took place in various segments that utilize in daily uses, that is mobile, then torch, then lights, then portable machineries required to operate where the electricity is not available. Secondly, battery is the thing which can get the electricity stored. As you all of know, electricity, once it is alternating current, is loaded on the grid, and if it is not utilized, it is waste. And battery is the device by which we can cover and we can store the energy in terms of utilization at the area where it is not covered with the electrifications. As the world moves from the industrial age to the information age, the rules of business have changed, and many ways we are entangling the solution every day. But if you see this battery, it is earlier in Agastya Sanhita, it is said that the formulas and all kind of things are available and described in Agastya Sanhita, where this simple earth pot is available, and when you are separating two electrodes with sawdust, and if you add the CuSO4 solution, this can be generated. There was a shloka, Santapyam Mrinmay Tamrapatram Susatkritam Chadachi Griven Chardarbi Kashtam Pasumbi Dastashloshti Nidhatvayam Paradascha Distastatsva Sanyogajayate Jajo Mitravana Sanjitam. It means that a place a well cleaned copper plate in an earthware vessel, cover it first by copper sulfate and then moist sawdust. After that, put a mercury amalgamate zinc sheet on top of the sawdust to avoid polarization. The contact will produce an energy known by the twin name of Mitra Varuna. Water will be split by this current into Paryavayu and Udanvayu. A chain of 100 jars is said to give a very effective force. When a cell was prepared according to the Agastya Sanhita and measure, it gives open circuit voltage as 1.138 volt and short circuit current as 23 milliamp. So I will play one video to get more about it. Is it audible? Okay. It explained that you take a pot, then take two plates, copper and zinc, insert into the pot, and if we connect with the voltmeter, then it will not show the current. So Agastya Sanhita had mentioned that in between the two steps there should be a sawdust. So we have added now the sawdust and separated both the poles. Now see the sum voltage produced, that is 0.11718. Basic to add sawdust to separate the two plates. To complete the things, it is mentioned in the shloka that you Shivagriya is the neck of the peacock. Basically, it is a color this is basically you use for the confusion to the other scientists of other words, not to utilize our technology. Basically, it is a solution of copper sulfide. See the color, both the colors are same. Now we will add the solution into the container. Now you can see there is a voltage increase. It is 1.06. It is said that Mr. Volta had created the battery in the year 1860, whereas Maharishi Agastya created this battery 5000 years ago. As per the August Santa, he said that use 100 such pots to create the voltage, but for this experiment we are took 3 pot and we have created 3 volt charge, electric charge, and we have connected this circuit with small bulb. And you can see it is ignited. If you want to have more voltage, you have to increase number of pots according to the requirement. Earlier in Asian era, we have the bulb and it is shown in the sculpture. The snake type of figure is nothing but a bulb and there is an element inside it. And at bottom, there is wire connected with the pot. See, here from here the wires are coming out and here it is connected with the pot. The utilization of technology utilized to create the chaos earlier, where the chaos are in the darkness, and this technology were used for the creation of this huge chaos with multiple sculpture. Because earlier it was said that they might have used small lamps and all kind of things generated the heat and smoke, but if you see the traces of smokes and carbon oxide, it is not available in the caves. It means that they were utilizing this technology earlier. Thank you. Next is how this battery looks like and what are the components. Everybody knows there is a cathode and anode and it is separated with these things, and this way the structure we see it in the battery. Okay. And earlier when this Volta invented this battery, it is a Holotech pile. He made compilation of this pile with copper as a positive electrode and zinc as a negative electrode. Thereafter, Daniel Cell come into the picture. That about 40 years later, a British scientist Daniel Cell created this Daniel Cell, and it is an electrical potential become the basis unit of voltage equal to 1 volt. The Daniel Cell basically utilized for various purpose that time, and it used the salt bridge formation to connect multiple cells to generate the power. Thereafter, this evolution of presently used lead acid batteries come into the picture, where this lead acid multiple plates of the lead utilize as a positive load, and it will be separated with positive and negative electrolyte. Water plus sulfuric acid is being used to generate 12 volt supply battery, and it is still we are using this lead hold batteries in various cars. Thereafter, for small use purpose, this nickel cadmium cell battery being invented and being utilized for other application like torch, even small kind of the equipment where the electricity is not possible to use, this battery's backup is being utilized and placed for getting the work done in earlier age, because wherever the electricity is not available and the transmission lines were not installed that time in 90s also, this is being used. Thereafter, alkaline batteries being invented. In alkaline batteries, it is if you can see the popular brand, they are the Duracell and Energizer. They have invented this battery, and the details are given in this battery norms, where the current collector, anode, separator and cathode is being given. Positive cap is at upside and negative cap is downside, and 10 billions of alkaline batteries have been made in this world till date. Thereafter, next evolution in the battery come when the nickel metal hydride battery is being invented, and that can be used for this shown application, including small gadgets and as well as small electric vehicle and mobile phones also. That time some different kind of cells were being used, small cells. Their further evolution is of lithium ion battery. Now it is used being used in various mobile application, and it is very small in nature, and it is very safe comparative to the other batteries. And this Sony released first commercial lithium ion battery in the year 1991. So you can see the pictures of this battery, and it is very good in utilization. The power generation and power utilization ratio is very good in this battery. How it works: when the battery is charging up, the lithium cobalt oxide cathode gives up some of its lithium ions, which pour through the electrolyte to the negative graphite anode and remain there. Discharge: when the battery is discharging the lithium and moves back across to the electrolyte to the positive cathode, producing the energy that powers the battery. In both cases, around the other outer circuit, electrodes flow in the same direction to the ions inside the battery. You can see the figure, and you can.
Hello. Please share your PPT.
Ha, sir. Okay, okay. 1 second, sir. Is it not visible? Hello.
Not visible, sir. Please share.
Now, is it visible? Hello.
No, sir.
Now is it visible, sir? My screen is visible.
No, sir. The sound is audible.
1 second, sir. One sec. One second, sir. Now is it visible?
Starting to show. Yes, it's visible.
From which slide it was not visible? From 13th or from 12th?
From 9th.
You can see from this.
From 9th slide, sir.
Okay, I will repeat. Okay. Now is it visible, sir, again?
Yeah.
Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Hello. So there after that Daniel cell, it was a lead acid battery. Currently also it is being utilized in various vehicles as a startup to the IC engines. It's give the startup voltage and the IC engine can run thereafter. The lead acid battery contained lead dioxide positive side and further separator and the lead negative side. These are the lead cells connected with positive and negative, and the, for electrolyte there is a water plus sulfuric acid solution being utilized, and it generates 12 volt for power per battery. Thereafter, nickel cadmium NiCd4 batteries being invented in the year 1899 by Waldemar Jungner in Sweden. The first ones were wet cells similar to the lead acid batteries using a liquid electrolyte. Nickel cadmium batteries help pave the way for modern technology, but they are being used less and less because of cadmium toxicity. Because of this toxicity of cadmium, these nickel batteries were not being further utilized, and thereafter it is being replaced with the alkaline batteries. Alkaline batteries do not have this toxicity, and because of the potential utilization capability, over 10 billion alkaline batteries have been made in the world, and it is still being in process. You can have the names called Duracell and Energizer. These are the main producer of this alkaline batteries. Thereafter, nickel metal hydride batteries come into the picture and being utilized for the gadgets, various electronic gadgets, including torch and even for the various tools to operate where the power transmission line is being not utilized and not available the electricity. Thereafter, the very new technology of lithium ion batteries being produced, and it is in the year Sony released the first commercial lithium ion battery in 1991. Lithium ion batteries have high energy density and have a number of specific cathodes formulation for different application. Lithium nickel cobalt aluminum oxide cathodes, also known as NCAs, are used in the batteries of vehicles such as the Tesla models. Tesla models are the very innovative models coming into the picture for light electric vehicles, and they are testing continuously. Lithium cobalt dioxide cathodes are used in laptops and smartphones nowadays. Our laptops and smartphones are based on these batteries. Thereafter, this how it works, lithium ion LCO formulation, how it charge and how it discharge. When the battery is charging up, the lithium cobalt oxide cathode gives up some of its lithium ions, which moves through the electrolyte to the negative graphite anode and remain there. When the battery is discharging, the lithium ions move back across the electrolyte to the positive cathode, producing the energy that powers the battery. In both cases, around the outer circuit electrodes, electrons flows in the same direction to the ion inside the battery. This is the structure, and when it works, it flows like this. The market of rechargeable batteries, according to the energy requirement, you can see the graph. From 0 to 50, it is the lead acid battery. From somewhere 20 to 70, it is NiCd batteries. From 70 to near about 110, it is nickel MH battery, and now the lithium ion batteries are very much popular, and it can be generated from 110 to 170 specific power generation. You can see the higher current and higher running time for this, the lithium ion batteries are very good into the solving the purpose of the various instruments and gadgets and modern technology for which we are utilizing it on daily basis. Now what next? For the next, it is called string cell battery technology, the future for electric vehicles. I am jointly working with Mr. Vinay Salodkar ji on this project. This project is very interesting, and I will request Bode sir to continue with Mr. Salodkar sir regarding this string cell technology. Further, what I am doing here, I will let you know regarding my company. We are the partner for various businesses creating pathways, that is avenues for revenues to achieve sustainability. We provide services to the existing manufacturing unit for setting up new projects if they want to take up backward or forward integration. Say for example, somebody is in trading business and selling the rods, then we can give him the technology to produce the rod. Further, we can scale up for specific application the rod technology. We innovate and create solutions for every industrial need by re-engineering their processes about productivity improvement, capacity enhancement, quality consistency, and definitely it will lead to profitability. We give strategic planning, includes market survey and feasibility report for new startup. We design and manufacture special purpose machine as per the requirement of customer and client. What is the, as per me, what is the ABCD of life is work start when you take action, hope ends when you stop believing, love ends when you stop caring, and life ends when you stop dreaming. So dream big, work smart, hope for good, and love all. Make your life purposeful and beautiful. Thank you very much, Bode sir, and the team of esteemed panelists of Rayasoni Group of Institutes. I'm thankful again, and thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Manav Barge, sir. Next case. Padmanabh, sir, please.
I'm audible to all. Good morning to one and all present over here. I would like to introduce Mr. Vinay Salodkar sir, which having an MSc in statistics, graduated with substantial technical expertise in various fields. He has been very actively engaged in the development of the technology, which is driving force of the product. He born at 6 September 1963, education in MSc Statistics, year 1986. Working experience having vast range over here. You can see he is a chief of faculty CCIT, Tilak Nagar, Nagpur. Year 1989 and 1994. He is proprietor for VS Computers for banking software development 1995 to 2014. Proprietor for Unique Computer Books Library, Nagpur, Pune, 1919 to 1914. He is a concept development IIP, Internal Information Provider, for 2004 to till date. He is the development of Oracle 9i. 10G Oracle Certification Association till date from 2007. SAP Base and Advanced Certification Association from 2007 till date. Development of SIM card based camera in GSM camera 2008 from 2008. Development of Wi-Fi based fixed PTZ camera 2009. Development of remotely controlled PTZ portable camera 2010. and development of website app Twistcasting 2013 in Japan. He is a prominent fellow of a technological driven institution, and he developed many things over a period of time. And now I welcome Vinay Savarkar sir to take charge of the event and go on with his presentation. Thank you, sir.
Namaskar, everybody, and I just want to begin with thank you for my introduction. Thank you, Rasoni, for giving me this opportunity to speak on the behalf. I want to confirm that my sound is correct and you are audible. Okay. I just want to confirm from you so that I will continue.
Yes, it's audible.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. So, Mr. Deshpande has already explained to us that our ancient engineering people, okay, they know what the battery is, and he has explained nicely about the various batteries concepts which are brought in, and up till he has stopped up to string cell idea. Now the string cell idea I will continue, and the entire string cell ecosystem, okay, I will try to explain. In my lecture, probably the information which I want to share with is I am going to talk about the string cell battery. Okay, what are the problems in existing batteries and how string cell was evolved. Then after the string cell battery, probably we'll talk about more on the technologies which are used in string cell batteries, and there are more things out of the box which I am going to show you, and probably I am going to show you, share some videos and some presentations step by step. So at the end of my lecture, if you have any questions, you can write to me, or you can even ask Arvind sir to communicate with me, even if some questions may be arise after 1 or 2 days. Okay, maybe that will happen, but no problem. I will communicate through Bode sir, Arvind Bode sir, so that it will be easier for your student, the faculties and other researchers to look this particular idea. This is one of the very great occasion that Rasoni has conducted such a excellent informative talk on by Mr. Deshpande. Now I'm trying to continue with that idea again. Okay. Now, in order to begin with a battery idea, okay, what is up to Mr. Deshpande has explained. First of all, I will try to elaborate on what is the background which has actually happened because of what the string cell idea came into picture. Now, let us try to understand a very simple thing. You have seen that before mobile, there was an idea called pager. Now, pager used to just send, or if you call to someone and you receive a text, so it's again a one-way communication at that time. But it was a nice idea that unless anybody is busy with anywhere, he may not be near to a landline, okay, he can be communicated. And according to his availability, he will call back or he will understand what you want to communicate with. So from the landline, okay, the one step ahead is a pager idea. Now, after the pager idea, you have seen that the mobile came into picture. Now, once the cellular mobile idea came into picture, initially we just have the voice call, and the communication what you had on landline is now become mobile, so you can communicate in a two-way communication, okay, just like your landline, but now it is you are movable. So again, that was a excellent development, and the people are using that technology to a very long extent. But what the notice, what comparison I want to explain about is that on one side you think of the battery and on other side you think of the mobile. What you have seen that battery has evolved, but still the battery do not have its own intelligence. Okay. On the other side, mobile, yes, it has its intelligence, as well as the mobile becomes more smarter, and now how long that smarter will go again ahead of the things. Initially it was just a calling feature. Initially we just have to have communication, then we after that we have the other features of video call. We have the features like MMS, multimedia messaging system, not just text message. We have an idea of multimedia messages, and after multimedia messages we have the other ideas like you can have a video call. Now there are social media angle to the communication. So all these various generations which are coming into mobile, and compare that idea with our standard battery. Only thing what we notice is that a bigger batteries have been replaced by a smaller cylindrical batteries. And there is a nomenclature for the smaller cylindrical batteries. And it was very obvious, because once big battery, when it fails, it becomes very difficult to understand, because we cannot go inside the battery and check what has happened. We just have to depend on the current voltage, okay, of the battery. We have to understand that, okay, what has been wrong. Maybe if that particular battery is a lead acid with a liquid, we have to just check the liquid level. And hello, yes, we can understand the liquid level of a battery, and accordingly we'll have to understood what is the problem in a particular battery. Now after the lead acid battery, there are so many other technologies which have came into picture, as Mr. Deshpande has already told. My idea is that similar to how mobile was smarter, the battery was not smarter up to that level. So this is our main idea in a string cell, or our TANKTWO batteries, TANKTWO, that is our website with the name TANKTWO.com. So the initial idea was it is another tank where the tank also can be used for a smarter battery. That was our initial idea. So comparing with the mobile technology, how it becomes smarter, okay, the batteries we need to become smarter. So in order to make a battery smarter, what are the difficulties? We have to step by step understand that particular thing, that in a cylindrical battery, the general nomenclature is that there is a standard diameter of a cylindrical cell. Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
Can you share your PPT, sir?
Somebody's okay.
So,
in a standard cylindrical battery, the size of the battery is determined on the diameter of the cell and the height of the cell. For example, what the battery we see in a day-to-day life called AAA battery, AA battery and all, there is a cylindrical diameter of a battery and the cylinder diameter and the height of the battery. Say for example, we got a battery of a size 18650. So in this 18650 battery, the first two digit, that is 18 is the diameter of the cell, and 65, that is 65 millimeter, is the height of the battery, and that last zero is the generation. Like you can have 18650, 18651, and so on. So this is the standard nomenclature which is used in cylindrical battery. What we thought of, that what has been done in the ancient, okay, in the history about the cylindrical batteries, why they arrived on cylindrical batteries. So we found that the cylindrical shape is very easy, and just to break up the bigger batteries into smaller one, it is very easy to put that particular cell into the cylindrical shape instead of the rectangle, square and all other shape. Okay, that is the only idea behind putting up or bringing up the cylindrical battery. Now we thought of that, if you want to improve this particular battery to a greater extent, like I just want to give an analogy to understand this particular idea. We want to make a battery smarter, but at the same time, the battery should be in a position to understand the nature of the application. The battery is basically can be used as an intelligent idea in a particular application. That application may be electric vehicle, that application may be energy storage, that application may be in our day-to-day life what we use a gas and a burshan. Okay, so there are electric heating pads or electric we can call it as a combination in Indian language as electric chula. Okay, so the batteries can be used in many applications, but the batteries must be in a position to play a role that can analyze something. Today, if you see that, if you see a battery in electric vehicle, if you see a battery in energy storage, there are concepts which are called BMS, that is battery management system. And that battery management system plays an important role in order to understand the things. But battery alone, battery of its own, do not have any intelligence. So we thought of that, making that battery as an intelligent to a greater extent in a step-by-step manner, what we need to do. First of all, what we see that a cylindrical size, that is just now I explained 18650, where 18 millimeter is the diameter and 65 millimeter is the height. This particular battery, I want to use it in say electric vehicle. Just now Mr. Deshpande has already explained you about that the battery can be used in a Tesla vehicle, which is a very popular vehicle in US, or maybe there are many vehicles in India also now that we see a lot of batteries which are coming in. The basic problem is that if I want to change the battery or I want to look into, I will tell you one example to understand this particular scenario. In a initial Tesla car, okay, which is of 85 kilowatt of battery in all, there are 7104 cells, that is 7104 cylindrical cells together constituting a 85 kilowatt of battery. Now how they are arranged? This 85 kilo battery is basically arranged in 16 layers. Okay, there are 16 layers of battery. Each layer is having 444 cells, and these 444 cells are grouped together in some combination. In any battery, when you try to replace a bigger battery with a smaller cylindrical battery, the terminology which is used called SP combination. That is how many cells can be put in series and how many cells can be put in parallel to form a group. Okay, so series and grouping is called SP combination. So in this 444 cell, let us say there are around 16 cells which are used in group, and maybe there are 11 such groups, etc. So 16 layer of battery with 7106 cells in all. Now it is impossible to check each and every battery for the current and the voltage for each and every battery. So BMS plays a battery management system plays a very important role into it. Problem is that if I want to swap or I want to change, I want to check all these batteries, then becomes a very difficult job, or it is a time consuming job. Why I'm saying a time consuming job? Because we are born and brought up in an environment where we are using petrol or a diesel or a gasoline vehicle, where when you went to a station, I mean the petrol station, you just require only 2-3 minutes or 5 minutes to fill the tank, what we use, maybe a two-wheeler, three-wheeler, or maybe any other kind of vehicle. So our habit from the childhood is feel it and forget it. I mean, just feel it, whatever the fuel you are using, whether it is a petrol, diesel or gasoline, just close the tank and use it, no problem about it. But that is not the case in battery. Okay, even the Tesla car, what you have seen, okay, or you must have heard about, and there are some electric vehicles in India, it takes hours together to charge the batteries. So in order to charge the battery or in order to swap the battery, this is one more problem what we find, and we want to solve this particular problem, okay, in order to that particular battery can be easily swappable. That is our goal, that is our idea, that okay, we want to develop a battery which can be swapped very easily. Secondly, the battery which can be utilized for multiple purpose. Now try to understand, this is very important thing. Today what happened, you use a battery in your mobile, in your home inverter or a UPS system, or in your college or department there are inverters and UPS. You are using a battery for your electric cycle. You are using, maybe using in future, the battery in your car or a scooter and so on. So I want to use a battery which can be used in multiple locations. But that is not happening currently. Currently, I cannot use my bicycle battery into the car. I cannot use my scooter battery into the car. I cannot take out, as I told you an example, that electric chula. If I had a battery in my electric chula, I cannot take out those electric chula battery and put it in my car or in my scooter and utilize it again. So these are the basic problems, or the technology needs to be improved in this particular way also. So slowly what I'm trying to explain you, that in order to make a battery smarter, we are having these hurdles. So what is the first important hurdle? The hurdle main important is the size of the battery. Because it is a cylindrical battery, I cannot just take it out and swap it immediately. It takes long time for me to swap or to take out the battery, check the voltage, check the current, and again put it back. So we need a battery where the batteries can be used, but at the same time, those batteries should have a wireless idea. It should not have wire. And the second important thing is the shape of the cylindrical battery. We notice that many of you, when you are in your early education of 11th or 12th standard, you must have learned in algebra or in mathematics that ellipse and ellipsoid shape, just like what you have learned in circle, triangle, square and all, but you also have learned what is called ellipse or ellipsoid shape. So what we thought of, that why not try various shapes in order to solve this problem of swapping. And in order to solve that problem, what we come a very interesting thing, that our first ancient battery, which was developed by Agusti Rishi, as explained by Mr. Deshpande, okay, that battery was an oval shape. If you have seen that presentation, okay, so we thought of that oval shape can be a very good combination, where all the edges of the oval, okay, it is looking something like an egg, okay, and that particular shape can be used in order to solve this problem. I will just show you a sample battery so that it will be more clear to you to understand this particular thing. Just a minute. I think now you can see a battery on the screen, okay, and this is oval shape battery, okay, and you see that this particular size is 40 millimeter and this particular size is 20 millimeter, and this battery is a oval shape. This is weighing only 38 grams, and the most important is, as you have already seen the size, it is very light. Now it does not require any wire, okay, and there can be number of such cells inside a tank or inside your battery tank, and that can be communicated with. Now let us try to understand one by one the idea. Now first thing I have explained to you is about the shape of the cell. Instead of the standard cylindrical size, I am using an oval shape. And because of the oval shape, the age of this particular cells on all the side, when I put into the tank, okay, I do not require a wire to get in touch with other cells. It automatically get connected to the edge. You put this cell in any way, maybe upside down, left side, right side, downside up, whatever way, in any angle. But in a tank, when the cell goes in, the cell automatically gets connected through the edges. So this is a very important thing. The most important thing is we have already developed around 27 patents from Japan to US in 7 categories for this particular cell. So this is one of the wonder of the universe that this cell came into picture. And I am very happy that I am one of the team member of this particular development. Now let us slightly go ahead and try to understand some more things out of it. As I explained to you, the shape and the size, the weight is very light. It is only 38 grams. So in a standard battery, you may have now a question that what happens if the bigger batteries or the cylindrical batteries are used, and instead of this particular battery is used. I will roughly can tell you about that. If I use this battery, by 25%, the weight will be reduced of your battery. And minimum 15% of the volume which we are currently using can be very well reduced with this particular idea. So in all, 25 plus 15, 40% of your battery space of cylindrical size batteries can be very well reduced to this simple idea. Now you could see that I will show you what is inside of this particular cell. Okay, just a minute. Now you could see that there is a cover on the top. Okay, this is the cover on the top, and this is the cover on the bottom. And in between, you could see a white color thing. And that white color thing is basically, I will show it on this module so it will be more clear to you. Now, this is your bandage. If you try to understand in a simple way, the idea of the battery is just like if your finger is cut, you put a bandage on your finger. So you can understand that this is a bandage which is used inside the battery. And this particular battery has everything inside in this bandage. That is electrolyte, cathode, anode, separator, and so many things. They are all inside this particular bandage. And you don't need any external things out of here. So this is the cover which we used. Okay, cover is already known to you. Now there is very interesting thing. As I told you that I want to make a battery smarter. So in order to make my battery smarter, we have this chip, and that chip is called ASIC chip. ASIC stands for Application Specific Integrated Circuit. Okay, now you could see this is a chip. Okay, and this chip is basically world's first battery with a 6 terminal. This is very interesting. Now you may not have heard anywhere in the world that you can have a battery with a 6 terminal. What we know is a battery with only plus minus, and that too 6 terminal. Recently on a battery day, Tesla has announced a battery called tabless battery. It means there is no positive cathode on the tab, or the tab on the upper side of the cell in cylindrical size. But that idea we have developed in 2012. We are far ahead of that technology. Now I want to show you this particular chip which is inside the cell is doing a marvelous things into the battery application. I just want to show you on back side of the chip so that you will understand what I'm trying to say again. Now you could see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These are the 6 terminals. And again, these particular six terminals are not fixed one, they are dynamic in the sense that I can use any terminal for any other purpose. So this is the basic idea behind communicating this string cell with other string cell. Or in short, if any of you must have heard idea what is called as network theory. So in a network theory, there is a idea called mesh. So these cells actually form a mesh network inside the tank and get communicated by just connecting to the edges. It does not require any wire. And this is the world's first battery with a six terminal. So just I want to show that battery once again. So this is the battery. The nomenclature is very simple. This is 3.6 volt battery with 3600 milliampere hour, weighing only 38 grams. The dimension is 20 mm by 40 mm and it can generate just a 10 watt. Now we have done an R&D of up to 100 watts. So in order to understand that, just compare these cells, you will understand that, okay, this is the cell. Now see the layers into it. Okay, this is the cell with 10 watt. Now I'm going to show you some more cell, which is now this particular cell, and see the windings and see the circular yellowish part and the aluminium foils part into it, and that is 75 watt. And see the this is a 10 watt cell, and this is a 75 watt cell. And this 75 watt cell is more dense, it is more powerful, and it is very interesting that we have developed up to 100 watts of combination. Now let us come back to understand more about it. Okay. So till what we have seen? We have seen that the battery can be made smarter. It is need of the hour. We have around 27 patents with 7 categories. Categories include the tank, the cell, the architecture of the battery, the inside energy storage capacity, and so many other things. So what is our idea? That a battery can be made smarter. Yes, it is now you can say, because you already seen it, and I am happy to share that this is the world's first battery with a six terminal. Now let us try to understand about how the six terminals are, because you must be now curious about, we have seen only plus minus two terminals and that is fixed. We know what is cathode on plus side, on top, and on bottom side, negative, that's all. We never heard of a battery with a six terminal. So let us try to understand. As I already explained to you, the six terminals, they are like this. The first two terminals are plus minus. That is a standard cathode and anode combination. The two terminals, the next two terminals are what is called as passive terminals. Now, passive idea is basically, the thing is, you can make this particular string cell, the individual string cell, as an isolation from other group of cells. That is very important feature, because that you cannot do in your standard cylindrical cell, maybe used in any car or any other application. Okay, the cylindrical cell, I cannot take it out if there is a damage unless I check it out, and it is a time consuming process. And because my chip is inside, the ASIC chip inside my cell with a software can control my battery, I can make use of these passive terminals to isolate this cell from other cells at any point of time without any problem. So this passive terminal are used in order to isolate this particular cell from other cell. And very important thing, because of my cell is controlled through a software, or there is a firmware inside the chip, okay, my battery will never get fire. It will not catch fire at any point of time. Now this is very interesting thing, and I am going to tell you the story, why we had this particular idea and what is the advantage of this. When we have demonstrated this idea, to be more precise, we have developed this string cell idea in year 2012. We have started in 2008. It takes 4 years for us to concrete on idea that yes, there can be a string cell which can be developed. From 2012, it takes around 3 years more for us to develop the first prototype, and we have launched that on 11th of September in Detroit in US on a battery show. There is a very big exhibition and conference always mostly on 11th of September. Now this year, due to pandemic, it was not done. It was online, but on every year the battery show was conducted with a very large number of participants in North America, and we have launched that particular string cell in 2015 on 11th of September. There was a great appreciation from the world people who came over there, and there was an interesting thing which has happened with us. One of the US Defense Secretary person asked us that your battery seems to be a different from shape, but why it is different from others, can you explain? The answer which I have given, I am trying to explain to you also, that this particular battery, because it never will catch fire, and not even that, every battery actually generates a heat, and that heat, when it will go into the sky, if it is try to understand a scenario that this particular cell is used in a application like drone, and this cell, when it is used, and if there is a heat which is generating from this cell, it will go into the sky, and there will be a heat signature as the drone is moving ahead. So it will form a heat signature. Maybe that drone may not be attacked because it is not traced on radar, but that drone can be traced by the heat signature. And this is exactly what has happened in US and Yemen war, which was a very small war on some 3 or 4 years back. Now, actually, I had some problem because of the power failure, and now the power again back. So maybe I may be miscommunicated for 2-3 minutes. Permit me that, because the power again has come back. So it may happen that for a moment there will be some disconnection. Just bear with me for that. So what happened is that drone, when it is going ahead and ahead, the heat signature is formed, and that heat signature was traced by the system, and it has been attacked. And this is very important thing, that if the drone can be attacked by the heat signature, it is very dangerous. So in our string cell, that problem has been solved. Our string cell does not even allow the heat signature to be generated, and this is one of the very important feature. And because of this feature, we got US Defense and Lockheed Martin as our client, and we are with Lockheed Martin in 2017. It's a very big company, and it's a very aggressive in drone application, in marine applications, and in so many US defense applications. So let us come back to the idea that what up till we are seeing, that this battery is with a 6 terminal. This is oval shape, and it does not require a wire to be get attached with. Okay. Now, the most important thing out of which is, I can even swap this particular battery with the hand, because the operating voltage is just a 3.6 volt. You will not have any kind of a shock current or any other problem which we generally have when you touch any AC current or something like that. There is all DC current, and that too very small. That is just a 3.6 volt. So just like you can take that particular battery out from a box, put it in other batteries combination, that is absolutely no problem. I can even use this battery combination of different size, different version with my application. Now there is very interesting thing, that my battery, okay, can be used with multiple application. It automatically gets configured of its own. Generally, in all cylindrical batteries, when you use, you need to configure, you need to reconfigure depending on which application, change of the position, change of the vehicle, change of the application you are using. So that I don't have to do because there is a software inside, and that software automatically take care of this particular thing. So just like as I told you the example, that if my battery from the bicycle, my battery from the scooter, I cannot interchange, that problem we have solved with this particular string cell. I can use this string cell in any other devices, in any other application, immaterial of whatever the application is. Now let us try to understand some more ideas about the string cell. That is the chemistry, the application usage, and so on. And the most important is the environment application, the environment in which this particular application is used. These particular cells are even environment friendly. I will explain to you step by step. First of all, these particular cells, as I told you, can be swappable with a 6-terminal IDEA, with very lightweight and all that. The most important thing is, many people not aware of that when you use battery, actually we can use the battery up only 20%. So when it becomes a 20%, your battery shows it is a zero. So from 1 to 19%, we can never use a battery because it is used for the internal purpose. And that problem also we have solved with string battery. What we have done, because of our firmware can control the battery, we can use the battery up to 1%. So this battery is giving you another 19% more usage compared to any other standard cell. So as I told you, the 25% by weight, 15% by volume. Now this another 19% of the battery, you can use still more because of the firmware, the configuration inside the battery is used in such a way that it can be used up to 1%. And this is very interesting thing in our competition, that no other batteries can match to our battery from so many years. Let us try to understand some more ideas, okay, about this particular battery. Now there is a very interesting question you might be thinking about, that okay, the batteries are good, that's okay, the weight is good, okay, but what about life? What about the life cycle, the charge discharge life cycle of this battery? Now try to understand, whenever any battery is manufactured, it may be nickel cadmium, it may be lithium ion, it may be LiPF4 sulfate battery, it may be LiSOCl2, any combination you can take. In my string cell, I can have 175 combinations which are possible. And there is no restriction as such. It can go in up to 300 in future. Chemistry is not a problem for my battery. I can have any number of chemistries combination. And the most important is, my battery life can be designed in such a way that it can be used from 3 years to 40 years, 40. Remember, I'm repeating again, from 3 years to 40 years of life. And not even that, my battery can be even recycled, because you already seen in my battery, there is a jelly roll or the jelly inside. The bandage can be recycled. The chip is having a life of 200 years. If the cover is damaged, that can be changed. That is very less, the price of the cover is very small. So my jelly roll or the bandage can be recycled. My chip is having 200 years of life. The cover, if it is damaged, can be put new one. In this way, I can recycle my batteries, and my battery can have first life, second life, third life, and so on. So this is very interesting thing, that the battery can be manufactured in any combination. Generally what happens, when any manufacturer manufactures the battery, first of all, he has to fix on chemistry, and he cannot change the chemistry, because if he tries to change the chemistry, okay, the combination of battery may be lost, and he cannot do a business for more longer time. But that is not a problem with our battery. Our battery's combination can be changed, it can be recycled. And as I already told you about the 6 terminals, the weight, and the 1% IDEA, and so on. So this is the added feature in my battery. And because of this, this is a universally accepted battery in future. It's very important. It's very important that such a battery, it takes around from 2008. Such battery. It is not a small effort. 8 years of a long involvement to develop the battery, and still it is continuing. There are some more modifications which are going to come, and there will be more versions which are going to come into this particular battery. And because of the idea that this battery can be utilized to a greater extent, now I'm going to show you some small videos in order to understand the swapping idea, how this particular battery is very useful when it gets swapped. Just a minute.
System for electric vehicles. We are. Tank 2. Most electric cars take many hours to charge. High-speed chargers are a lot faster, but still cannot go much beyond 70% in less than 40 minutes, which is still very slow. We replaced the traditional battery pack with many small and intelligent string cells packed randomly in a battery container. This is what we call a string battery. We employ a high-speed air transportation system to move the string cells in and out of the vehicle. Swapping all the string cells takes less than 3 minutes. The string cell holds a rechargeable lithium cell and electronics for sensing, measuring, switching, routing, and communication. By using high-energy density cells designed for smartphones and tablets, string cells are inexpensive and hold a lot of energy. First, the system maps the randomly located string cells. Next, specialized algorithms calculate optimal routes. A string battery works logically as one large battery pack. Tank 2 powered cars can be charged from an outlet, just as any other electrical car. However, when there's no time to wait, cell swapping offers a fast and easy way of getting a full charge in less than 3 minutes. The Tank 2 string battery makes range anxiety a thing of the past. Thank you for your time. Please get in touch with us at tank2.com.
Okay, now you understood about from one small video that how these string batteries can be swapped very instantly. Now think of that if these string cell batteries are used in your bicycle, in your scooter, in your car, in your drone application, in your electric chula, and the other applications like the inverter, the UPS system and all. So it becomes very easy for you to use the same cell in multiple applications. The swapping is very, very important idea. It actually reduces our time of charging the cells. And it is a very great effective cell in the ecosystem of the battery as such. Now we'll have a small demonstration, a small video to understand the running of the string cell, how actually when it put into the tank, okay, how it is running. I will just try to demonstrate that small video in order to understand how, in a simplest way, how the string cell works. Just a minute.
member. I am Bert. I'm the founder, and we have here to demonstrate the simple version of what could be considered a string battery. Tanker makes string batteries for all sorts of applications, including like cars. And, you know, battery packs obviously can be very large. So when we go around and do demonstrations, we've been asked to do it with the simplest possible version that we can build. And that's this. So this setup consists out of basically two parts or three parts. So one is the tube, which is nothing else than a passive translucent container with two compact terminals on the extremities, the actual string cells themselves, so the egg-shaped devices that contain the energy, and then the user interface, which is essentially a tablet, but then thicker. So this video is unedited, except for some alteration in speed to make it a little bit more interesting, but no cutouts or no modifications otherwise. So this is how the demonstration goes. So an operator, in this case, tank to engineer, fills the tube with string cells. So there's no specific orientation of any kind. That is actually one of the core concepts of the string cells, is that the cells are packed randomly, and the software is smart enough to figure it out. Here what you see is that the engineer is agitating the tube a little bit, which is normally done by an automated process, but well, since this is as simple as possible, you need to do it by hand. In the user interface here, you can see that the process starts off by actually trying to figure out which cells are in the tube and how they are oriented relative to one another. And this is done by sending a series of impulses through the tube, which all the individual cells sample and then are correlated to make it work. So there's a series of things that happen to collect the information, but all this is transparent to the actual end user. So there's a lot of data that is being collected to make this possible, and it is happening in several iterations. And actually, a little bit paradoxically, in this incarnation where you have actually the smallest possible string battery, this is a more complex problem mathematically than it can be in a regular sized battery pack. And that is because the opportunities here for creating contacts is much more limited. But nevertheless, the algorithms are flexible enough to deal with anything. And it's a good illustration of how it works. So here, this image which was flashing by, it's a visual representation of the map that has been created based on the contacts and the paths that have been discovered. A certain amount of optimization is done to figure out if this is actually serving the actual need right now. And what you see here on this display is a set of information that tells something about the actual circuit that is going on, including the temperature of the individual cells, the output current, the number of cells in this string, and then the series voltage. So in this case, the series voltage is 44 volts, since there's no electronics involved here. So this is the actual voltage, which also the load will get. We have the option to have things with DC-DC converters, which allows for essentially any voltage to be created independent of the actual string voltage. So the demonstration which is sent to customers is identical to what you see here. So we're going to repeat the process. So where all the string cells that were delivering power, so now are essentially shuffled around, put back into the container, and the process is restarted. And if you would look at the data, very much in detail, you will see, of course, that the results of the measurements are going to be completely different, but the output, of course, is going to be the same. It's possible, actually, in this case, that because one or more cells or less can be put into the string, so therefore you can actually have a higher or lower bus voltage. Again, in normal battery pack, not an issue, but in this simplest possible form, This is one of the variables that we have to live with. Process again, exactly the same. Initial measurements based on pulses of electricity sent through the pack or through the tube in this case. And the algorithm does all the hard work of making sense of the data that the individual cells are spitting out. So the sequence generally is first initial measurements, collecting data, mapping is creating a logical map that describes how the cells touch one another, and then a routing algorithm is used to determine how the cells actually should be connected, because what you'll see is that there are always more options, more than one option, to hook the cells up, and if you have a regular size battery pack, anything essentially about 10 liters or bigger, the amount of options that you get really skyrockets. So it's essentially almost infinite. So again, these demonstrations here, they are available for customers themselves. So there we have the three-dimensional representation of the data again. And the optimization process starts right now. And when that's complete, power out, which is essentially the command that sets all the candies into action, is given. So that is essentially everything there is to it. So this is on purpose, not very polished. This is on purpose, not accelerated. So to have here is absolutely the minimum possible demonstration of the tanker technology. You can power a car with it, obviously, but it can power a lot that is not sensitive to the output voltage. Actually, we see here that now the cell configuration led to 51 volts, which again is fine in a normal application. The variance of the voltage can be specified by the customer. So if you want a load that is happily with a range of, for example, from 300 to 320 volts, that's what you can get. If you live with a wider tolerance range, that's fine as well. It's just a matter of making sure that the customer specifies exactly what this application requires, and the system is then dimensioned accordingly. So this was that. If you want to have a demonstration in person, get in touch with any of us. My email address and phone number is going to be here.
So I hope that you at least a little bit understood about the string cell and how this particular string cell work. Okay. We'll just have 5 minutes break. We'll just have 5 minutes break, and I will arrange some more technology. So the applications which I'm going to show you, just in 2-3 minutes, I need to think. Questions? Yeah. Arvind sir, kai prashna tumhi sang किंवा नाही चेंज करतो एक दुसरा डेमो आपण हे करू. सर तुमचा आवाज खूप कमी होता.
आय रिक्वेस्ट द पार्टिसिपेंट टू राईट डाऊन देअर क्वेरीज ऑर द क्वेश्चन ऑन द चॅट बॉक्स सो दॅट आय कॅन आस्क टू द अवर गेस्ट. हॅलो सर, check the chat box
and
There is one question.
So, can you explain the chemistry of these cells used?
Sir, our cut to
hello. Can you give the details about the chemistry about this cell?
आवाजच नाही येत सर
अगेन. एक्सक्यूज मी सर. हॅलो सर, कॅन यू एक्सप्लेन द केमिस्ट्री यूज बिहाइंड दिस सेल्स?
ओके, केमिस्ट्री यूज इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर सेल, यू अंडरस्टँड दॅट? ओके, सो द नंबर ऑफ केमिस्ट्रीज यूज, एज आय टोल्ड यू दॅट currently we can use around 175 chemistries, starting from simple lithium combination that may be Li4, LiMn, and so many things. As such, there is no restriction on using a chemistry. I will tell you one more example. You must have understood that there are so many cells which are used currently with so many other chemistries combination. Now there is one more thing compared to a battery that is called the ultra capacitor batteries or the super fine ultra capacitor or long term ultra capacitor batteries even. Now the best thing is, in my string cell I can have a combination of lithium and ultra capacitor combination I can use in this string cell. So absolutely there is no restriction for me of using any combination. You may not get a combination of a lithium ion Li along with the ultra capacitor wire or combination which are used in ultra capacitor. I can even combine that together in my string cell. So it's a very great technology, because of I can use any permutation of combination, starting from a life of 3 years in life cycle, okay, to up to 40 years. I can have a life cycle of starting from just 300 life cycles per chemistry to 100,000 life cycle per chemistry. Absolutely there is no restriction. I hope you understand.
Yeah, sir. There is another question. How you can utilize this string cell battery for the mobile like application?
Actually that mobile version will be some different application, okay?
Yeah.
that will come into the pouch, a smaller pouch combined together, or a sort of a small bullet, okay? Just like you have a nip in your ball pen. That nip size ball pen cells combination can be utilized in the mobile application, and there you can use this particular idea. But in that case the size of the chip will be very very teeny small, it may be in microns, okay? So that is to be understood.
Sir, one more question. Sir, what is the time taken for the charging of the battery? Means we have the variation of the battery from 10 to 100 watts. If sir, we are going to charge 100 watts battery, then what is the time duration for that?
Okay, now I will just show you one picture where this current 10 watt batteries are getting charged, and how they are getting charged. I will just show you that picture, and then I will explain to you. Just a minute.
Okay, sir.
Now I hope you can see something on your screen, and in the video I see video picture here. Okay, can you see this picture now?
Yes sir, the picture is clear.
Now you can see that the white end This is basically our mobile charger wire. This is mobile
okay,
charger
sir.
Connector. And there are 6 cells on this. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And it takes only 1 hour. If the cell is fully discharged, it takes only 1 hour to charge
okay,
this
sir.
Particular battery. Now, this is a physical charging idea because all
okay,
these 6
sir.
Terminals are connected. Now, there are other...
Servo network.
...which are possible. I don't have the picture of the same, but...
Okay, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. After the charging, the next possible is inductance charge, and there is one more technology for the charging purpose, and that is called Wi-Fi. That is just like for internet, you can have the string cell on the Wi-Fi also. We already got 4 for the same, and we are tied up with something called OSIA, OSSI from North America, okay? And we are going to have that wireless charging even for such batteries. In couple of, I hope your charging idea can be done.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's clearly understood, sir.
Okay. Okay. Any other next question?
Sir, no, sir. Not now. We can carry on our conversation.
Okay. Now I will continue with the next idea. So, this is all about just a string cell. Now let us try to understand slightly a different idea about the string cell, and that particular idea is we call it as a Google idea. Now I will explain you some examples, and then I will tell you about this technology, that how these particular string cells are a Google idea. You will try to understand, and this is very important USP of our cell. Now try to understand. Actually, around in year 2000, okay, I had developed one idea. You in my introduction, it is already told to you that I had developed some idea in India that is called IIP. IIP stands for Internet Information Provider. In those days, people don't know about how the internet is used for the applications, for the various ideas. Like if somebody is an architect, somebody is an art specialist, somebody is a lawyer, somebody is just a carpenter. So how internet can be used for his own professional work is not really understood. So I have developed an idea that is called IIP, Internet Information Provider. Prior to this idea I had developed in 2004. Prior to that, from the year 1990 to 2014, I had developed an idea what is called as Computer Books Library. From the idea, you in your Raisoni institution, there are so many libraries. People are accessing the books, people are accessing the CDs, the DVDs, and some more material. What I have done, through this computer books idea, I have gathered around 4,000 persons in Nagpur area, in Nagpur district. Okay. Then I have opened a branch in Pune, then I have opened a branch in Hyderabad and in Bangalore and so on. The most important is, people are coming over here, they may be student, they may be teacher, they may be software professional, there may be the entrepreneur or the owner of the company, there may be consultant and so many other people. People used to access my books, and because of the books, I could understand that what is the need of the people, what they want to study. They want to learn Java, they want to learn PHP, they want to learn computer hacking, or they want to learn computer forensic, so many subjects. And they are paying me monthly, maybe some 100 rupees or 200 rupees like that. So in turn, my knowledge is get increased to a many fold thousands of times I could gather my knowledge and I could understand what the industry is doing. At the same time, I'm earning also. This particular idea was in our string cell also. Now try to understand how it is. When try to understand a scenario that if in some municipal, Nagpur Municipal Corporation, some electric bus has been used and that driver is using this electric bus. Now, if the driver for electric bus, there is only forward gear and a reverse gear. There are no other gears which are required. So, if the driver has used the accelerator so many times and where the vehicle was optimized in a proper way or not, I can determine this with the help of my string cell data. Now, I'm trying to understand or trying to explain you how the big data concept was used in my string cell. And this is a Google idea. Try to understand that my string cell, maybe it costs 200 rupees, but the data which is generated on this string cell after every 2 minutes for a year, 365 days, there will be a data center for my string cell. There will be a DR, data recovery center for my string cell. And there will be an entire blockchain database ecosystem for my string cell. And the data which is generated will value not less than 5,000 rupees per annum on the basis of one single strand. So my cell may be costing just 200 rupees, but the data which is generated on this string cell will give me more than 5,000 rupees per annum at least. Because the string cell, the data which is generated, just like you have an Aadhaar number, unique ID, my each string cell has a unique IDs. My string cell can be controlled from my mobile application. My string cell voltage, current, the life cycle, how many charge discharge life cycles are there. I will know each and every cell, string cell life cycle on my app. Not even that. What is the residual? I mean, what is the life which is remain on a string cell? That also I will get updated automatically. So there are around 26 parameters which the data for which is continuously generated and stored in a big data fashion in blockchain database in my server or maybe on my network. And the servers could be country specific, it could be global, it depends on the application. So this data is going to pay me more than just the cost of the cell. So try to understand that in a standard battery, which may be cylindrical or a bigger battery, if there is a battery problem, that battery problem is because of what? Maybe damage, maybe some other things. Now those all problems I can analyze with the string cell and I can give more idea that how is the behavior of the vehicle, how is the intelligent the vehicle used just because of my string cell. And this is fantastic. This gives me a lot of information, and this is our Google idea that's going to pay us in future. Now, apart from the battery application, I am going to show you some pictures and some ideas about how this string cells ecosystem, as I told you, the blockchain, the ideas, there are how communication between the users, the petrol stations, the manufacturer, how that structure can be. Just I'm trying to show you some pictures to understand this particular thing. Just a minute. Now, this is what is building blockchain and smart contract, how you can develop or program the blockchain idea. I will just repeat once again that blockchain, how it works compared to a standard database system like Oracle or maybe SQL or some other combination. Blockchain is an idea where it is not centrally located. I will try to explain the idea just like with the example of a banking application. If you have one account in your bank, your account is actually stored in the bank server at a particular central location. But in case of blockchain, this particular account will be stored in more than four places, and that all these four places data is synchronized with each other so that nobody can singly change the content or modify the content of a blockchain database. So this is a simple idea compared to a standard database where the data is stored singly. In case of blockchain, the data is stored on a multiple locations and they are synchronized with. Now try to understand the other idea, that is how blockchain is used in my application. Okay, now on the screen, you have seen the Tanko ecosystem. Now here, you will see that these are the vendors which are occupied. This is the car holder, the car owner. This is the petrol pump station. And on the center of the thing, this is all data center combination. The data is stored, the data is modified, the data combination, it can be used. And on the right side of the screen, you will see that there are ecosystem components which are used just like your payment gateways. You have a payment gateways in your bank application. There will be payment gateways in my Tanko ecosystem also. And with the help of this all combination, I don't have to pay anything in cash. My entire cash or the transaction will be done online, and it will be through mobile apps and its combination. So this is just to understand how the Tanko ecosystem will work with the blockchain idea. Okay, now let us try to see one by one. Now there can be a stakeholders in this. There are data privacy things. And the smart contract is basically the way the blockchain string cell can be programmed. And my string cells are IoT and IIoT based. That is Internet of Things and Industrial Internet of Things. Both are included. Both these technologies are the part of my Tanko ecosystem. And because of that, the distributed and it is something like a ledger in your bank account. Just like you have many transactions, credit, debit, by cash, by clearing, by, that is by check, by online payment, by NEFT, by RTGS. So in a similar way, this is a ledger of each and every cell where all these 26 parameter transaction will be noted. And you can find out, you can analyze from those transactions from a time to time. Now you could see that in the center of the thing, now there are various APIs, the application program interface. In the center, you could see a ledger. Then there are smart contracts which are used in order to manipulate all this. And there are other users who can use this particular application. Initially, each and every user, where he is a user, where he is a manufacturer, he is a trader. So many, many people can register first. So there are registration APIs, then there are trending APIs. So I will come to know what is the trend going on which particular way that I can understand. So this is in short the ecosystem of my string cell. Now this is the picture which explained me that once my car goes into the station, the user can track it, the authorization can authorize that, then my factory and the user can go on a registration and the distribution also can take place. So this is all a broader picture to understand how this particular combination can be used. In the next slide, okay, I am trying to explain that how big data is used. Now see here, I can have a user, I can have a trader, I can have a leasing company, my sale even can be leased. This is a very important thing. Try to understand the batteries which can be given on rent, that is possible with my string cell. So you are sitting at home, but you own suppose 1 lakh of batteries and you put that into the market just like a share market or your mutual fund market. You can even trade these string cells. Okay, that is the beauty of this particular string cell. Okay. Now, with this small idea of a blockchain ecosystem and all, okay, we'll slightly go into the other aspect. Now, I want to show you one video, okay, and that video is very interesting video. This is a video related to Swami Vivekananda, the great saint of India, and Nikola Tesla. Now I'm trying to divert you on a very small different topic. Just try to listen to this video.
However, Tesla failed to complete it.
Okay.
Few people recognize the extensive lobbying contributions made to modern science by Nikola Tesla. Having registered over 700 patents worldwide during his long and eventful career, the prolific inventor was a true visionary and a gift to modern human progress. Although Thomas Edison is credited in popular culture as the father of the light bulb. Indeed, all industry as we know it today owes Tesla great debt. Nikola Tesla, who was born on 10 July 1856, has long been a fascinating and enigmatic figure. While his contributions to science went underappreciated for years, his work light a system of arc lighting. Some say his concepts during the following years were greatly influenced by Veda. The Vedas are considered the earliest literary record of Vedic civilization. The most sacred books of India consisting of hymns, prayers, myths, historical accounting which date back at least 5,000 years. The nature of matter, antimatter, and the makeup of atomic structure are described in the Vedas. The language of the Vedas is known as Sanskrit. Once Nikola Tesla says all perceptible matter comes from a primary substance, or unity beyond conception, filling all space, the akasha or luminiferous ether, which is acted upon by the life-giving prana or creative force, calling into existence, in never-ending cycles, all things and phenomena. This proves that Tesla was aware of ancient concepts, and the correlation it had with the science he was working on using Sanskrit words like akasha and prana to describe the force and matter that exists all around us. These words come from the Upanishads. According to the information obtained from the archive in the Nikola Tesla Museum, Tesla gained knowledge of the Vedic terminology during meetings with Swami Vivekananda. Leland Anderson, founder of Tesla Society, suggested that it was through association with Swami Vivekananda that Tesla may have come into contact with Sanskrit terminology. During the 3 years that Swami Vivekananda toured the United States and Europe, Vivekananda met with many of the well-known scientists of the time, including Lord Kelvin and Nikola Tesla. Nikola Tesla was much impressed to hear from the Swami Vivekananda his explanation of the Samkhya cosmogony and the theory of cycles given by the Hindus. He was particularly struck by the resemblance between the Samkhya theory of matter and energy and that of modern physics. In 1895, Swami Vivekananda shared with Tesla the idea of matter and energy to be one, and requested him to prove it through mathematics. However, Tesla failed to accomplish it. Vivekananda also interacted with the other two giants of Western science, namely William Thomson and von Helmholtz in New York. Eventually, after 10 years, in 1905, Albert Einstein proved the oneness of matter and energy, E=mc². Nikola Tesla, taking original knowledge from Vedas, invented many things that we all use on a daily basis, but most people have never even heard of him, because his name was removed from common history, just like much of the teaching of the Vedas, and he was eventually murdered. He knew too much and wanted to share it freely for the betterment of mankind, not to exploit it. Unfortunately, not everyone saw eye to eye with him. In ancient India, some selective greatest teachings were passed to the deserving sages verbally, which remained stored in their memories, so that the power of knowledge is not misused by demonic beings, referring to texts, if it were written. Only the knowledge which was helpful for mankind were passed to common human beings. True to this belief of Vedas, all Tesla's engineering was done in his head. He never worked things out on paper or used scale models to come to a functioning final result. Things would appear in his head, and he would simply record it exactly as it came to him, similar to Beethoven. Tesla died with the Brahmastra scalar interferometer knowledge in his head. As he did not want to give this destructive Vedic technology to the US military and Vatican, as promised to Vivekananda, it was to help mankind, not to destroy or enslave. What do you think about this? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below.
Okay. I hope now I have put the idea of himself into some different energy related idea. Why I diverted this? Because now I am going to show you a small demonstration of this particular idea, which was developed by Nikola Tesla in so many years back. And I am really, I'm really happy that I was one of the team member of development of this particular idea, which I'm going to demonstrate you now. And this will be a live demonstration. What we have done, we have developed an idea of a combination of a generator, an alternator, and a motor. Okay, try to understand this particular scenario. The generator, the motor, and alternator, we have coupled together all these three to demonstrate that energy can be generated. I am not saying that I am going against the law of thermodynamics. This is just a mere idea that explains how Nikola Tesla and how our Vedas and all other old generation ideas can be even still can be developed. And I'm just going to show you one particular application. Before going to that particular idea, first of all, I want to explain a little bit about that idea. As I told you, that string cell battery needs to be charging. Naturally, in order to charge the battery, anybody will think of that using a thermal power station power to charge the string cell will not be a good idea. We are talking about much more on environment and so many things. But if you are still using a thermal energy to charge the string cell, will not be a correct idea. So what we have done, we have developed this combination of coupling of a generator, the alternator, and the motor. And this combination is a regenerative idea. It is not regenerative braking. Regenerative braking is the idea where when you put a brake and that power is used in order to add to your motor or to the generator. This is something which increase the output of the generator more than 100% in order to get the power, an additional power, which power is basically used in order to charge the batteries back. Try to understand a scenario where I got 1 kilowatt of generator. That 1 kilowatt of generator is attached to on a front side to a generator, which is an AC, which is giving you an AC output. Okay. I will show you along with one diagram to understand this particular one. That diagram will be very easy to understand about the concept. Just a minute. Now I try to understand particular idea. Here I got 12 volt, 60 ampere, 4 batteries. Okay. Now this 4 batteries, 60 ampere hour is driving my 1200 watt motor. And connected to this motor, there is an AC alternator which is giving me output of 1 kilowatt. On the back side of this AC motor, there is 930 watt DC alternator. And this DC alternator is charging the battery back. And there are some gears combinations which are used in order to couple this motor with my generator or alternator on both sides. Okay. So now I'm going to show you a one live demonstration of this idea. And that idea was yes. Now I'm going to demonstrate you the idea that we have developed a bicycle, a scooter, a three-wheeler auto rickshaw, okay, and some generators. So fortunately today I have with me one model of scooter, the electric scooter, which is just a 250 watt, and I will show you how the generator, alternator, and motor combination use in a particular vehicle. Just allow me, I'm going to downscale the picture to you. Just a standard scooter, and this electric a motor on the back side on the in the in this wheel.
Is it the problem of the sir?
Now this particular electric scooter गडबड झाली ते गरम झालंय तुमचं चालू आहे का ते चालू करा तुम्ही जस्ट म्हणे ना होल्ड ऑन ते तिथे स्क्रूड्रायव्हरचा सेट आहे स्क्रूड्रायव्हर सेट आहे तुम्ही घेऊन जाणार So it is going a speed on a stand itself. My scooter is on stand and it is going at the speed of 25 kilometer per hour. And on the bottom you could see 0.1 kilometer. Okay. Now slowly I'm reducing the speed. I will show you. But okay, now you could see the. No, this is the standard of. Try to understand the generator here on the bottom. Now we start that. Now this generator combination, the generator alternator, now charging my battery back. Okay. And this is something which is very unique. So what Nikola Tesla has given us a direction that can be still implemented in the current scenario. This is my just a small effort to understand how this battery combination can be utilized. If you're interested more, I can have some more demonstration afterwards. Okay. Yes, sir. बुधे सर आता अजून काय हॅलो
आता आवाज येतोय
तुम्हाला हॅलो
रेडी रही
हॅलो
छान सर हॅलो येतो येतो हॅलो हा कोणाला याच्यामध्ये करायचं आहे तेवढं विचारून सेशन आता इथे थांबवत
क्वेश्चन पूछना आहे का
Participant, suppose you want to ask any question, please write from a
chat box
so that we can have a comment
and session.
Ah, sir, there is one question. Sir, you are a vehicle. So, this is the initial energy required for starting the rotor.
In order to start that, it actually gets started from the battery.
Yeah. Okay. Means you require the battery.
Just like I will explain in little bit more analogy of a car. When in a car you start an alternator, when you give an ignition, your alternator actually drives your engine. And once the engine stabilizes, in turn, engine then rotates your alternator, and then alternator charges the battery. In a similar way, this works over here also.
It's a reversible process.
Yes. Instead of that petrol or diesel or gasoline engine, okay, you have a generator alternator combination that works. And there is an alternator, DC alternator, which is used in order to charge the battery back. So in this scooter example, I got 12 volt, four batteries, of 28 ampere hour, and these four batteries actually used to drive my generator alternator combination and the motor. So 36 volts have been used in order to start the alternator and motor combination, and 48 volts total battery. Okay, 12 volts are used in order to charge the battery back, because my batteries are 12 volt, 4 in numbers. So that 12 volt out of 48 is used in order to recharge the battery back, and the generator output is more than 100%. Generator alternator combination output is more than 100%. So that remaining part was used in order to charge the battery, and the main course is to drive the motor.
Excuse me, sir. So there is one question from my side.
Yeah.
Sir, how much time we additionally means buy with the aid of this arrangement, means a generator and motor, to increase our life cycle or to perform the vehicle on the road?
Actually, it is very simple idea that once you charge your battery only in the initial part, only for once, okay? Later on, whenever you feel that your battery is down, you just start your button of an alternator generator combination and it will charge your batteries back. So just like I told you that on a scale of 100% battery charge, there are five divisions, let's say 20% each division. If one first 20% is reduced, you start your alternator generator combination, immediately it goes on starting charging your batteries. So when you are running, when your scooter is on stand, or it is locked, or it is parked, still the generator will charge your battery, absolutely no problem. So the life cycle of the cell will definitely going to increase. If a cell has a life cycle of say 1 year, it is going to increase by another 20 to 30%, maybe highest is 50%. So that is the reason. In current scenario, the batteries which are used are a standard lead acid or a lithium batteries. But when my string cell will come into picture, I will not have that problem. Even those charge cell I can swap and I can utilize it for my further applications. So in that case, the problem of battery, again, the life cycle of a battery problem will be extended to a greater number of days, years, no issue about that.
Sir, I would like to ask one question.
Yeah.
In cold weather conditions, we find that in spite of having the battery, it is difficult to start the vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
So how this care is taken in your string battery so that cold weather conditions does not affect the starting of the vehicle?
Okay. Now, in a standard scenario where it is an electric vehicle or it is any other fuel vehicle, you have seen in a demonstration that my battery actually has a temperature sensor inside. Okay? So each and every battery has a sensor inside. It does not have a problem of the cold weather or something like that. Okay, if you are talking about the sub-zero temperature, okay, then my batteries will be different. Okay, these standard batteries, I cannot use it for sub-zero temperature. But what the experiment we have done in US and in China and in Japan and in some other countries, the sub-zero temperature also my battery can sustain. Only thing is, it depends on the chemistry. To my sub-zero temperature, the chemistries I can use like LiSOCl2 and some more combination. So as such, temperature is not an issue with my battery, okay, because there are temperature sensors. So automatically that problem is taken care of in my group of cells which are used as a reserved part to initiate the triggering of the cell as such.
Thank you, sir. And another question is from my side is that what is the overall cost reduction when we have put the string battery instead of the regular batteries?
Okay. Now, as I told you that my string cell are compared to 1F650 standard lithium ion battery, but the chemistry is not fixed. So whenever you want to compare my string cell with other batteries, we are comparing with which chemistry is very important. Standard thing is Like in my lithium ion cell, okay, if compared to my standard lithium ion cell, maybe around 10 rupees it will cost more per cell in my string cell. It depends on the chemistry, it depends on the life cycle, it depends on the application.
Sir, there is one question for the student. Where we can see your this invention in
now? Yeah,
to have a demonstration, live demonstration.
Yes, I can even give you the live demonstration. I am trying to bring all my demonstration pieces to Nagpur because they are currently in Delhi to the Prime Minister office to see that particular thing. In some weeks time, all these demos will come back to Nagpur and I will inform you. You can then arrange a demo. I can give you a live demonstration. No problem.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, one and all. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. First of all, I would like to thank Honorable VC Ma'am, Dr. Meena Rajesh, and Dean School of Engineering and Technology, Dr. Bharati Sayankar Ma'am, for allowing us to organize this great event. I, on behalf of GH Ryerson University School of Engineering and Technology and its entire organizing team, extend a heartfelt thanks to Engineer Deepak Deshpande Sir, SES Business Solutions Director, and Sri Vinay Salodkar Sir, Executive Director, GreenTech India, for giving their valuable knowledge on evolution of battery technology and string cell battery technology and other technology also. Thank you, sir, for sharing your valuable knowledge and time with us. I would like to thank all the participants for making this event successful. Finally, I would like to thank Ajay sir, Arvind sir, Anup sir, and Padmanabh sir for organizing this great event. And thank you, everyone. So, Arvind sir, please proceed.
Yeah. On the behalf of GH Ryerson University, I thank you, both of you, sir. I am hoping that the same and relation and health leaders perform your
best.
So, everyone, please fill the feedback link for getting your certificate. It is mandatory to fill up the feedback form. So kindly fill the feedback form. The feedback link is shared on the chat in the screen box.
Okay, thank you, Vinay sir. Thank you, Vinay sir.